their own shield, and cruel were the ravens' cries that feasted on the field, saying, "Black water, cold and clear, will never clean your wound. There's none but the maid of the winding mere can make thee hale and sound. So course well, my brindled hounds, and fetch me the mountain hare, whose coat is as grey as the washed water, or as white as the lily fair, who said, 'Green moss and heather bands will never staunch the flood. There's none but the witch of the Westmorlands can save thy dear life's blood. So turn, turn your stallion's heat, till his red mane flies in the wind, and the rider o' the moon goes by, and the brightest star falls behind. Clear was the paly moon when his shadow passed him by. Below the hills was the brightest star when he heard the howlet cry, saying, "Why do you ride this way? And wherefore come ye here? I seek the witch of the Westmorlands that dwells by the winding mere. Then fly free, you good grey hawk, to gather the golden rod, and face your horse and tear the clouds above yon gay green wood. And it's weary by the Ull's water, and the misty brake fern way, till through the cleft of the Cuxton Pass the winding water lay." He said, "Lie down, my brindled hounds, and rest, my good grey hawk, and thee, my steed, may graze thy fill, for I must dismount and walk. But come when ye hear my horn, and answer swift the call, for I fear ere the sun will rise this morn you may serve me best of all." And it's down to the water's brim he's borne the rowan shield, and the golden rod he's cast it in, to see what the lake might yield. And wet rose she from the lake, and fast and fleet gaed she, one half the form of a maiden fair, and with a jet black mare's body. Loud, long, shrill he blew, till his seed was by his side. High overhead his grey hawk flew, and swiftly he did ride, saying, "Course well, my brindled hounds, and fetch me the jet black mare. Stoop and strike my good grey hawk, and bring me the maiden fair." She said, "Pray sheathe thy silvery sword, lay down thy rowan shield, for I see by the briny blood that flows you've been wounded in the field." And she stood in the gown of velvet blue, bound round with a silver chain. She's kissed his pale lips ancient twice, and three times round again. She's bound his wounds with a golden rod, full fast in her arms he lay. And he has risen hale and sound with the sun high in the day. She said, "Ride with your brindle hound at heel, and your good grey hawk in hand. There's nane can harm the knight who's lain with the witch of the Westmorland. Turn, turn your stallion's heat, till his red mane flies with the wind, and the rider o' the moon goes by, and the bright star falls behind.